I got a big goddamn problem with the news. You ready for this? The news is completely manipulated. Everything you hear every single day is designed by corporate media to do one thing and one thing only.
Jesus.
To keep you living in fear.
Oh, fear?
Total fear. Fear so you'll go out and you'll spend money on things. Things you probably don't even need. Things you probably already have six of. So that their advertisers will keep buying ads on their stations. I'll tell you one more thing. You ready for this? I'll do this all day, man.
100 years ago, there were very few scholars of Islam who stood up to declare that the paper money monetary system that was coming out of Western Europe was bogus and haram. Very few. But the established scholars, the establishment, they betrayed us. And they gave us this paper money. That's what they did 100 years ago. And now, 100 years later, we are on the brink of a pit of fire. Before I go in my grave, I want it to be recorded in my book that I asked. I beg you, go and ask your scholars. They cannot avoid giving an answer. Force it from them. They must answer you. Tell us, is it halal? Or is it haram? We are on the brink of a pit of fire. That's right.
What makes us realize that the monetary system is fraudulent? If today the British pound collapsed, and you have 50,000 pounds saved in your safe at home, when the pound collapses, you open your safe. What will that paper be worth? The paper will be worth nothing. But with that 50,000 pounds, if you bought gold and silver, and the economy collapsed, and you opened your safe, will that gold and silver have value? The answer is yes.
We in Islam, we insist, based on the Quran and based on the Sunnah, that the only money which is halal money, the only money which is acceptable to us as money, is money with intrinsic value. The value of the money must be in the money, and it has to be a value created by Allah. That value can fluctuate slightly based on demand and supply, but that does not affect the basic thesis of intrinsic value of the money. All forms of cryptocurrencies, all forms of electronic and digital money, all, and all forms of paper money in the world today, all of them are devoid of intrinsic value. They all have fictitious value, and therefore they are all plainly and clearly and manifestly haram. You cannot create money, you cannot create wealth out of nothing. When will the Mufti wake up and say what I have just said? What kind of money will survive after the Armageddon? Answer, we who follow the religious way of life, whether you be Hindu or Christian or Jew or Muslim or Buddhist, if you follow the religious way of life, after the Malhama, you would know it is your gold and silver coins, land and animals, which will store value for you. Okay. What is characteristic of IBN and of Inshan, who is a much younger man to me, is that they are following this order from the Lord God. And anyone who follows this order will become unpopular because you step on people's toes. When you stand up for what is right and you stand up against what is wrong and evil.
When Europe took over the rest of the world, one of the most important things that Europe wanted to do was to dismantle the system of real money and replace it with paper money. And they achieved it because the scholars of Islam were eating halwa. And all the natives start dancing, drum beating. We have something called independence, while Europe is laughing its head behind the wall. Look at them, blind like bats. Europe would not decolonize until Europe was ensured that a new financial system was in place. in which real money was now replaced by paper money.
This bogus and fraudulent and utterly haram paper money, which of course we can defend anytime anyone wants to challenge us or not, is going to be replaced with electronic money, which will be more haram and more dangerous. I thought it's coming in the future, it's already here. Imagine my surprise, based on my study of Islamic eschatology, 2 years ago I realized that the same people who have given us paper money in order to rip us off and to reduce Indonesia to abject poverty, the same people who are now giving us electronic money in order to have a system where you have espionage to track down every single transaction and to be able to close an account whenever they want to, whenever it's convenient, the same people are going to bring back gold and silver tomorrow as money.